By the authority given in the statutes of the Open University, I declare this congregation open for the conferment of degrees and the presentation of graduates. Distinguished guests, graduates, and friends of the university, it is my privilege and pleasure to welcome you all to the third of the Open University's degree ceremonies being held in 2014. It is my great pleasure to welcome our honorary graduate, Dr. Sarah Waters. We are delighted to be able to honor her today. We were due to confer an honorary degree of Doctor of the University upon Mr. Tony Benn at this ceremony. Sadly, as we know, Tony Benn recently passed away. So this honorary degree will now be conferred posthumously at a later ceremony. This year, the Open University will award over 14,000 degrees, and more than 7,000 of the graduates are being presented for their awards at degree ceremonies such as this one today in London. These are being held in 13 different towns and cities throughout the UK, as well as in Dublin, Versailles, and other places as far apart as Moscow, Bucharest, and Addis Ababa. Now, this illustrates the extraordinary scale, scope, and reach of the Open University, underlining the fact that today you are joining a worldwide community of graduates. It goes without saying that today is a very important occasion in the life of you, our graduates, your families, and loved ones, as well as the university staff who I hope you feel have nurtured and supported you. You could be forgiven for feeling that the occasion is so important that it needs to be a solemn. You would be quite wrong in every sense. This is a day of celebration. So, we will be very disappointed if anyone crosses the stage today to anything less than thunderous applause or whatever other way you choose to express your enthusiasm and support. With that in mind, why don't all of today's graduates briefly stand and join me in expressing your thanks to all those in the audience who have helped and supported you on what must have been at times felt like a long and arduous academic journey. Please stand up. Today's ceremony will begin with the presentation of those graduates who have gained a higher degree and who have been able to attend here. They will be presented by Dr. Frank Monahan, Senior Lecturer in the Faculty of Education and Language Studies. We will then see the awarding of the honorary degree of Doctor of the University to Dr. Sarah Waters. Mr. Rob Humphreys, Director of the Open University in Wales, will present Dr. Waters, who will sign the honorary graduate's book and make a reply. Then we will continue our presentations of graduates with those who have gained first degrees. To conclude the ceremony, I will give a personal address to the graduates. I now call upon Dr. Monahan to present higher degree graduates.
Vice-Chancellor, I shall now present those graduates who've gained higher degrees and have been able to attend here in person today. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, I present to you, for a thesis entitled The Catholic Church, Religion and Politics in Post-Communist Poland, Secularization and Republicization, 1989 to 2007, Maximilian Fras. And for a thesis entitled A Study of the Playful Use of English Among Low Proficiency Language Learners on an Intensive Business English Group Course, David Han. And for a thesis entitled An Ethnographic Study of Everyday Interactions in an Innovative Learning Spaces, Constancia Pantidi. I present to you for the degree of Master of Arts in History, Nicola Halls. And for the degree of Master of Arts in Childhood and Youth, I present Alison Ingram. For the degree of Master of Arts in Classical Studies with Distinction, I present Anthony Reeve. For the degree of Master of Arts in Classical Studies, I present Amanda Bradley. Caroline Kane. Norma Vallis. For the degree of Master of Arts in Education, I present Sarah Ullman. John Hayes. Alison Lira. Monica Patel. For the degree of Master of Arts in History with Distinction, I present Joan Hornsby. For the degree of Master of Arts in Humanities, I present Maria Sideris. For the degree of Master of Arts in Music, I present Mervyn Hogg. Aileen Lightfoot. Jeanette Smith. For the degree of Master of Arts in Online and Distance Education, I present Ian Luxford. For the degree of Master of Arts in Social Sciences, I present Karen Duffy. For the degree of Master of Business Administration, I present Gail Anderson. Brian Charlick. Fiona Clotin. Jane Dixon. Lenka Dvorakova. Simon Evans Evans. Stefano Yorb. Simon Jones. Paula Kemp. Nick Mascari. Alistair McCandy. Sobia Nayar. Atsushi Amoto. Eduard Petukov. Clifton Fury. Tim Porter. Andrew Puddick. Catherine Ray. Irene Reinberger. Tim Sharrett. Andrew Smith. Edwin Smith. Richard Widdowson. For the degree of Master of Education, I present Louise Ballard. Anita Checker. Daniel Chan. Belle Cottingham. Laura Hewitt. Joanne Jarrett. Stephen Jenkins. Patricia Spencer. Vasiliki Sangari. Elzane Voslu. For the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Networking, I present Gordon Duncan. Kevin Ward. For the degree of Master of Science in Earth Science with distinction, I present Catherine Crowley. For the degree of Master of Science in Management of Software Projects, I present Rihanna Smithers. For the degree of Master of Science in Mathematics, I present Abid Makbar. For the degree of Master of Science in Psychological Research Methods, I present Marie Page. For the degree of Master of Science in Psychology, I present Tony Brooks. Kate Rossiter. For the degree of Master of Science in Science, I present Emma Robinson. And for the degree of Master of Science in Technology Management, I present Daniel Collins.
Provost Chancellor, colleagues, graduates, guests. The Cleddau estuary in Pembrokeshire, at the southwestern extremity of Wales, may appear remote to some, but for centuries it has been a gateway between Wales, Britain, and the world, a place of exchange, transition, and intermingling, of people, goods, and ideas. Today, the university honours a writer born and raised in Nayland, on the banks of the Cleddau, whose work is characterised by the intermingling of established fictional forms with experimental approaches. Sarah Waters is one of the foremost United Kingdom novelists of her generation. Her work tackles the deep human themes of relationships, friendship, and the interactions and dynamics of social class. It attracts both critical acclaim and a wide readership. Born in 1966, Sarah attended Milford Haven Grammar School before studying at the universities of Kent, Lancaster, and London. She later became one of our own, teaching for the Open University as an associate lecturer. Her University of London doctoral thesis on lesbian and gay historical fictions served as both inspiration and material for her own fiction. A number of her novels feature lesbian themes, although her self-deprecating and surely disingenuous description of them as lesbo-historical romps hardly does justice to their richness and depth. Sarah has taken gay and lesbian-themed fiction firmly into the mainstream, with readers being drawn to the power of the storytelling itself rather than those themes alone. She has written 5 novels, the first 3 of which are set in Victorian England: Tipping the Velvet, Affinity, and Fingersmith. The Night Watch and The Little Stranger are set in the mid-20th century. 3 have been adapted for BBC television: Tipping the Velvet, Fingersmith, and The Night Watch. Her novels combine thorough historical research and period detail with innovation in form. The Night Watch has a temporal reversal, with the stories of the main protagonists being told from the late 1940s back to 1941. The gripping plot of The Little Stranger, set in the late 1940s and exploring the nuances of social class at a time of major social and political change in England, is framed in the neo-Gothic style of a Victorian ghost story. The accessibility of her work belies the nuance, texture, and complexity of her plotting and drawing of character. In being mindful, as she puts it, to treat your minor characters well, her work echoes that of Dickens. It is resonant also of the 6th century Pembrokeshire invocation, Gwnewch y pethau bychain, the appeal by David, the patron saint of Wales, to his followers to do the little things. Sarah's novels have variously won the Betty Trask Award, the Somerset Maugham Award, and the South Bank Shaw Award for Literature. They have twice been shortlisted for the Orange Prize and 3 times for the Man Booker Prize. In 2003, Sarah was included in Granta's prestigious list of best young British novelists. She was voted Author of the Year by both publishers and booksellers at the British Book Awards and was winner of the Waterstones Author of the Year Award. Her new novel, The Paying Guests, to appear later this year, is eagerly awaited by readers and critics. Sarah's skills and accomplishments as a novelist, her commitment to her chosen craft, and her former association with the OU make her a distinguished and deserving recipient of an honorary degree. Provost Chancellor, by authority of the Senate, I present to you for the degree of Doctor of the University, Sarah Waters.
Receiving this. I have received a number of honours and awards over the years, but I have to say, in all truthfulness, this is a very special one for me. I was an admirer of the ethos of the OU long before I ever taught for it. My teaching years with it were extremely happy ones. My father completed an OU science degree a few years ago in his retirement. An aunt of mine studied with the OU too. So I feel a very strong personal connection with the institution. It would have been an added thrill, I have to say, today if I'd been able to share the stage with Tony Benn, and it's very sad that we were robbed of his presence. I'd like to think he's here with us in spirit. I'm absolutely sure he would have been a huge admirer of the OU. So, a very heartfelt thank you to the university for conferring this degree upon me. Thank you, Rob, for your very kind words of my books. But most of all, congratulations to everybody here. I've just finished a new novel after working on it for 4 years, so I know very keenly what it feels like to have got to the end of a long, long project. But of course, writing novels is my job. I do it full time. I'm very, very aware that for many of the many of you graduates here, you've probably fitted in your studies around work, around running families. I've always been in awe of the drive and the commitment of OU students. I joined as a tutor, as we were then called, in the late 1990s, around about the time I was just starting off as a novelist. And I remember dividing my days between writing my novel at my computer, at my desk, in my bedroom, and doing my class preparation and marking assignments at my kitchen table. My days were very divided. I taught on an arts course called A210, Approaching Literature, which I understand is still going strong. It was a lovely course. It provoked lots of lively discussion in tutorials. And the plays and the novels that we discussed on the course, Othello, Frankenstein, Pride and Prejudice, amongst others, they still have the flavour of A210 around them for me. I think they always will. Even the look of the spines of those books on my bookshelf still recall those very happy teaching years to me. In fact, when I thought back over my memories of teaching for the OU, I realised that they were strangely physical memories. The vivid yellow and blue of the OU course materials, which I realised on my gown. The rattle of audio cassettes as they arrived with the course materials. The slide of video cassettes into tape players. And the very particular pressure you had to apply when you were filling out the carbon-copied feedback forms on students' essays. Perhaps lots of those now in our digital age have disappeared, I don't know. But they made me realise, yes, what a very sort of, as well as a very sort of satisfying intellectual experience it was teaching for the OU, it was a very kind of hands-on experience as well. And of course, it was an experience that I knew was being shared by other tutors and by other students across the country, across the world, you know, in their own living rooms, at their own kitchen tables. It was something that breached geographical distance to create a real, unique sense of fellowship and community. Now, I can see part of that OU community here today. So again, I just want to say, well done you. We're celebrating wonderful things today. We're celebrating dedication, creativity, a passion for learning and knowledge. I'm very, very thrilled to have been a small part of those celebrations with you. Thanks very much.
Vice-Chancellor, we now come to the part of today's ceremony that marks the presentation of graduates who've gained a first degree and have been able to attend here today. The full subject and classification details are printed in the directory of graduates. I present to you for the degree of Bachelor of Arts with First Class Honours, Emily Austin. Vanessa Bird. Elizabeth Bramall. Elizabeth Corley. Suzanne East. Hadley Garland. Karen Lee. Juan Mosquera Ramayo. Laura Scott. David Seagrove. Emilio Velidros Estal. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts with Honours, I present Hannah Akomensa. Jonathan Anderson. Parveen Omir. Iona Ball. Roland Beeble. Elizabeth Birch. Lynn Butler. Jacqueline Clark. Michelle Kerneboy. Tom Cross. Milena Cruz. Liz Andewett. Stephen Dickey. Suzanne Early. Gillian Furless. Neil Faulkner. Alison Ferraro. Charlotte Fitzgerald. Christopher Forder. Janet Feroma. Hugh Gordon. Jill Gribble. Karen Grout. Mary Groves. Amy Hampton. Natalie Harland. Erica Hulboka. Mark Holt. Paul Ireland. Kylie Jenner. Marta Karasek. Lucinda Knight. Magdalena Kochaniowska-Guz. Ferdusi Laskar. Gemma Learmouth. Lynn Lewis Falcaro. Laura McCartney. Ian McLennan. Emma Mead. Catherine Meegan. Paul Melvin. Marzena Michalowska. Neil Molnar Brown. Karen Morton. Jared Nadal. Jude O'Donoghue. Susan Pardo. Annette Parsons. Carol Pezzett. Nicole Reed. Sarah Robertson. Chris Ryland. Artie Schwab. Lisa Scrivens. Sarah Shenton. Joe Smith. Linda Savinsky. Stevie Stratton. Charlene Taylor. Rosemary Wetherill. Anne Wilsdon. Simona Yassin. For the degree of Bachelor of Arts, I present William Bowerbank. Uyanga Bolgan. Jill Cope. Laura Falco. Frédéric Guillon. Diana Casabarum. Stephen Lewis. Peter Martin. Kay McRae. John McGregor. Andrew Slucock. Benedict Spencer. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with First Class Honours, I present Robert Alder. Kate Murray. For the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with Honours, I present Everly Bartlett. Wendy Beecham. Robin Dalgavel. Ryan Devlin. Darren Heath. Matthew Hopwood. David Osborne. Simon Reed. Philip Stiersacker. Derek Vella. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws with First Class Honours, I present Melanie Graves Anstall. Caroline Shotton. Sarah Smith. Amy Wolfson. For the degree of Bachelor of Laws with Honours, I present Leah Alvarez-Fuz. Sarah Cole. Letitia De Gil. Jonathan Fudge. Francesco Gabrielli. Lorchina Gabrielson. Tim Hickson. Amy Matthews. Mary Reeve. Maxine Ricketts. Sajjan Siddiqui. Kevin Stevens. Hamilton Usamon. Maria White. Lisa Uden. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with First Class Honours, I present Uta Cecchini. David Cutting. Holly Davies. Mark Eden. Camilla Elphick. Julie Ferguson. Catherine Forster. Yeah! Kevin Graves. Edward Gregory. Magdalena Gutowska. Katie Hagel. Ian Hawkins. Carenza Ireland. John Launder. Catherine Lee. Jason Lyons. Anthony Markson. Bridget Mazzy. Leslie Moss. Ulrika Özkan. Zoe Sari. Svera Sverason. Melanie White. Edward Wilde. For the degree of Bachelor of Science with Honours, I present Husseinan Ali. Lubna Alvi. Lewis Anderson. Denise Aniogu. Deborah Ash. Asim Ayub. Tatiana Babushkova. Barbara Bamberger. Aretha Banton. Matthew Benson. Wendy Benson. Nikki Bird. Georgina Briggs. Shelley Brooker. Alan Brown. Douglas Browning. Liam Butler. Ambika Chandramohan. Selena Clark. Ellen Compton Williams. Christine Crawley. Lorraine Croissant. Sue Crothers. Irene Crowley. Ben Dean. Andrew Dean Lee. Warwick Drew. Jacqueline Durand. Katrina Essam. Val Evans. Kosar Fatima. Lucy Flint. Donna Golby. Karen Goldberg. Maggie Haig. Jill Hilton. James Hudson. Hud Hussein. Janine Isgin. Sean James. Laura Jones. Yeah! Laura Jungwirth. Yeah! Regine Kalanger. Yeah! Grace Chibert. Evelyn King.
Thank you so much.
Maria Kyriakidis.
Thank you.
Andrew Lacklear. Emily Laurie. Sarah Lovelace. Angela Manchester. Michael Martin. Timothy Masters. Michael McGettigan. Francis McGranahan. Hannah Milsom. Gemma Morgan. Paul Morris. Robin Morrison. Kerry Nunn. Ogona Obi Obiagbozo. Marlene Olin. Augustina Omoye. Vernon Otto. Enekpen Ozigbo Esere. Andrew Palin. Katie Patchett. Melissa Payne. Alex Perez Agustin. Sarah Petty. Lorna Phillips. Melanie Pittaway. Amanda Pounds. Congratulations. Christian Rankin. Dubravko Ratkayet. Katarina Ribeiro. Duncan Robinson. John Ruddy. Caroline Sayers. Safina Shaheen. Jane Slee. Emma Smelly. Ariana Somariva. Rimante Stankevicute. Kirsty Stierbu. Takash. Vivian Takash. Paul Temple. Joanne Theobald. Marcel Tsu Lee. Grace Udo. Jennifer Watson. Nick Webster. Timothy Wickett. For the degree of Bachelor of Science, I present John Andrews. Kelly Brown. Catherine Cantelow. Is it Carousel?
Sarasale.
Tracy Sarasale. Jenny Day. Milena Lanzetta. Tanya Maggot. Innocent Mogida. Adam Obinquo. Chandran Pushparatnam. Emma Sayers. Perry Tapman. Valese. Helen Valese. Christopher Wood. For a foundation degree, I present Ashley Atkin. Dipti Badiani. Is it Ragini or Ragini?
Ragini.
Ragini Burns. Paula Hodson. Susan Jaffar. Ian McGarry.
Congratulations.
Joanne McLean.
Congratulations.
Julie Nangle.
Congratulations. Is it Tyrone? Tyrone.
Victoria Tyrone. For the Diploma of Higher Education, I present Claire Bland. Cara Collins.
Is it César?
César.
César, yeah.
César Cretu. And Tracy John Baptiste.
I think it's me again. Right. Distinguished guests, members of Senate, graduates, I am very pleased to be here in London and on this very special occasion. And what an occasion it is. As we celebrate the amazing feats achieved by each and every one of you who are receiving your degrees today, this is a very special moment in your lives. You are now the proud possessors of an open degree qualification, something that brings with it membership of a very exclusive group. Because although hundreds of thousands of people have earned qualifications with us in the 40 years since our first degree ceremony, it still takes a very special kind of person to reach that goal. It takes commitment, it takes self-discipline, it takes persistence, and above all, it takes courage. The courage to admit that there is something missing from your life, the courage to do something about it, and the courage to see it through and stick with it, even when you face so many barriers to success. All students. All students have to work hard at their courses, but for many of you, this had to be achieved while also juggling jobs, families, and the countless other demands of 21st century life. The personal and intellectual qualities required to do this are invaluable in life, and we recognize and celebrate these with you today. All of you graduating should therefore be very proud of what you have accomplished and the respect, recognition, and dedication that your qualification represents. The road has been hard, but the journey has been worthwhile. I could see that in your faces as you crossed the stage today, and I could hear it in the voices of your friends and families as they cheered you on. They are all so proud of you, but you should also be proud of them. After all, it was your friends and families who supported you from beginning to end. Who stood... Thank you. Now I'll have some more. Where was I? After all... After all, it was your friends and families who supported you from beginning to end, who stood by you when times got hard, and who took on the cooking and cleaning duties when you had yet another TMA to finish. I can see you recognize that. For you, as for many, the Open University offered opportunity to participate in an exciting journey of intellectual discovery, to enrich your minds, develop and enhance skills, and demonstrate the talents you knew lay within you. But what you represent is more than the personal qualities that you know you embody: intelligence, energy, and persistence. You also represent anything that our society needs. Today, you don't just gain the status of university graduates, you also gain a new responsibility. A responsibility to give something back, to contribute to your workplaces, to your communities, and to your families. Your graduations comes at a particularly significant period of change in the world of higher education, and the Open University is leading that change. With the launch of OU Anywhere, all undergraduate students can now access and download their study materials from their smartphones and tablets. Their major stride in higher education innovation was recently recognized with 2 Guardian Higher Education Awards. You will by now be familiar with FutureLearn, our very own provider of massive open online courses, or MOOCs. MOOCs are shaking up the way the world thinks about education, and we are working with other top universities, along with the British Council and British Museum, to deliver the next generation of world-class free online learning. To date, we have more than 250,000 learners around the world studying almost 500,000 courses. But while our eyes are fixed firmly on the future, we're not forgetting our proud heritage of quality. For more than 40 years, we've been putting you, the student, at the heart of everything we do, and that is something that continues to this day. When we first opened, science students were posted home experimental kits to work with at home. Now, the Open Science Lab is accessible to all. People all around the world followed the wake up of the Rosetta Space Probe, launched a decade ago, which will land an OU-designed instrument on the surface of a comet. There was much jubilation on Walton Hall campus when the Rosetta signal was received, and the craft's first words tweeted from 501 million miles away were, "Hello, world." Closer to home, we were pleased to announce our new chancellor, digital pioneer Martha Lane Fox, Baroness Lane Fox of Soho, who will be installed as chancellor in September. Martha recognizes how the OU is using new and emerging technologies to make higher education available to all, and while she's extremely excited about this appointment, it is our students, you, our graduates, that she can't wait to start meeting. Don't for a moment think that receiving your degree signifies the end to your education. It is merely the latest milestone on an educational journey that spans from cradle to grave. Remember the Open University motto, learn and live. It is there on your degree certificate, on the wall behind me. As long as you live, you never stop learning. Much of that learning will be formed with degrees awarded by the University of Life, but will be informal, sorry, with degrees awarded by the University of Life. But remember that we are always here, and remember that you will always be a member of our family. Above all, remember that you are now an ambassador for the Open University and all it stands for. A university that stands for social justice, for equality, for creating a society in which education and knowledge is accessible for all. A university that from today you can be proud to point and say, I studied there and I'm a graduate. Congratulations.